everybody. It's Are you trying to say hello too? Hey everybody, it's Premier Gal here. Today I'm going to be teaching you how to use the Whipster Review Panel in Adobe Premiere Pro. After the tutorial, I'm going to be giving you some general feedback tips that you can give your clients when they're going to comment on your video in Whipster. So let's dive in. First, if you don't have the Extension Manager downloaded, you need to install it. Simply go up to the Adobe Creative Cloud app on your computer, scroll down until you find the Extension Manager, and hit Install. Once it's finished installing, you can go online to download the Whipster Review Panel extension. Once it's downloaded, you'll receive a slide notification on your computer that the Whipster Review Panel has been added to your Creative Cloud account. If you do not get the notification, be sure to go to Adobe Creative Cloud Preferences and make sure that your file syncing is turned on. To open up the Whipster Review Panel, you have to go to Windows, select Extensions, and this is where you can open up the Whipster Review Panel. You will first need to log into your account. So since I'm already logged into the Whipster Review Panel, what I'm going to do is show you how you can create custom export settings in this update of the panel. So let's say you want to have the option to export with a basic text overlay, kind of like a watermark. To get this custom preset in the Whipster panel, you first have to go to your general file export media settings. So once you're in the export settings, under effects tab, you're going to check name overlay. In the prefix box, you can type whatever you like, then under format, just select prefix and suffix only. So that removes the file name. So now let's save this preset by clicking on the save icon, which is directly to the right of the preset selection at the top. Now we can go back to Whipster panel. Click set preset location. Now you're probably thinking, where the heck is the preset located? All you have to do is go to Documents, Adobe, select Adobe Media Encoder, and in one of those folders, it will contain your .epr file. .epr is the file extension for presets. And then voila, the custom render preset is there. So now you're ready to share your current timeline with your client. You can create a new folder in the Whipster panel if you don't have one for this project. Once you're in that folder, click on Upload Your Timeline. This will upload the current timeline that you have open in Premiere Pro. You can change the name of the project. You can also change the folder it will go into if you change your mind. You can also choose a custom render preset that we just made. Since this timeline has specific in and out points, select Obey In and Out Points, so that way it exports the correct portion of the timeline. So since the intent is to share this video with your client, when you hit share video after upload, you can create a custom message and then enter in the client's email. Then hit start upload, and once it's finished uploading, your client will receive an email that it's ready for review. So while it's uploading, let's check on another video to see if our client has left any feedback. The best part is, you don't have to leave Premiere Pro to do this. Just simply go to your video in the panel, scroll down, and you can see the comments there. You can reply to them, or you can check them as completed, almost like you're checking off a to-do list. Once you're done making edits, you can upload your new version in the panel. So I encourage you to go check out the Whipster Review panel. I put a link to download the panel in the description box below. So now I'm going to give you some feedback on how to respond to clients' comments on your video. I'm talking about the comments that are very general and related to a particular emotion or feeling, like, I don't like that color, or I feel like this part is awkward. Well, those comments are valid because they're related to an emotion and the client knows best, but it doesn't help you out as the editor of what to do next. How do I make that color that they like? What color do they like? rather than saying that their comment is wrong or that their emotion is wrong, we want to applaud emotion because it means that they're actually feeling something from your video. So instead, ask them, you know, why do they feel that way? Can they give an example? Do they have a link? Do they have a video that they can reference to give you so that way you can maybe do something similar to that in Premiere Pro? As video editors, our secret talent is always to be a negotiator and a problem solver. I find that that's one of our hidden talents as video editors, so always go back to negotiation. So those are my tips for today. Please give this video a thumbs up and please subscribe to this channel. If you're in the first 100, you're gonna be put into a lottery to win a I Love a Premiere Gal t-shirt. I also wanna give a shout out to Whipster. Please do check out the link below where the full blog is going to be posted and give them a thumbs up as well. Thanks again and see you next time.